Well, the house began as home and office, which it is now, though the office is moved out of the building. But it was in the house proper for the first 100 years and plus of its life. The office was on the second floor in the family quarters. And it, of course, you had the executive departments, you know, all the treasury and different buildings around town. In 1902, the offices were moved to the west, to a west wing, the executive offices, employees, 30 employees, 35 employees. But as it has grown, the West Wing has been enlarged, and they've gone into other buildings. There's the old executive office building, which is actually not an old executive office building. It's the old State War and Navy building made into an executive office building, but that has started in the early 20th century. Then across the street, you have the new executive offices, thousands of employees that are involved in the immediate executive responsibility for this vast government we have. So, you would have to say, though, that the office is, the president's office is still in the White House. It's adjacent to the Rose Garden. For him to go home from the Oval Office for lunch, if he chooses to work there, he just walks down a colonnade, if the weather's nice, and goes into the house, gets in the elevator, goes upstairs for lunch. It's not all that far. It's like going, what, two blocks, city blocks maybe, maybe more, but not a lot. It's not anything to wear anyone out. And he's right there. And then behind him, of course, is this vast office staff, beginning with the most intimate to his work and all. I think the Secret Service rejoices that the president's home and office have stayed the same, because if they had not, it would have been a problem. And back in the after the Civil War, there was an effort to move the president's conclave out to Rock Creek Park. I think it was more as an effort to save Rock Creek Park as a park than anything by the Corps of Engineers, but it was an effort to move the president out there, and it would be easier to protect, was what was said. Lincoln had just been assassinated and all. General Grant said that will not happen when he came to the White House. He said the president's going to stay in the historic house, and the Lincoln melodrama underlined all that, and it has always stayed, and it stayed one complex. But in fact, it is still the president's home, with the office in, kind of, so to speak, in the yard. I mean, the office is right there. The president can stay there all day. And since about the late 1970s, the president is there a lot of the time, except when he leaves town, because there's so many pressures for him to go to different parts of Washington that the Secret Service exerted a little influence. And most everything that happens with the president now happens at the White House. So the White House is used even more than it ever was. Yet it's until it's been open to the public as well, to look at the public state rooms. You don't have a stately house if no one gets to see it. But the president is right there, and so it is a home and office.